Hello friends, today we are going to discuss a topic which is related to the polity GS2 of the UPSC syllabus. Before discussing about the topic, my question with you all that can Delhi be the state or not? And I'm very much sure that after discussing the whole thing or completing this, going to the end, you will be in the situation that you can answer this either a yes, no, or something else. So let's start. Since 1951, the Delhi has its own legislative assembly that exists as per the Part C of the Constitution. But during a 7th Constitutional Amendment Act 1956, this amendment abolishes the structure of Part A, B, C and D. Part A, B, C, D are the part which describes about the state and the union territories or states of the country, and form a new act, that is a State Reorganization Act 1956. This particular act divides the whole territory of the country of India into two parts. One is state and second is union territory. The state, as we all know, that it is headed by the chief minister, and it's all a state has its own legislative assembly. But it is not same in, as in the case of union territory. Union territory is headed by the lieutenant governor. So at the same time, in 1956, the status of Delhi's as in a legislative assembly was abolished and Delhi become the union territory. In 1963, the parliament experiences that there should be a law or act about union territories. Some special rights should be given to the union territories, like a law passed by parliament in 1963, the Government of Union Territory Act, which gave Puducherry the first union territory with its own legislative assembly. But it was not happened with the Delhi. Delhi was waiting, but Delhi's status of state or legislative assembly was not actually happened. Later on, few issues arises, like the population of Delhi increases near about 2 crores. Then Delhi have its own unique culture and it's required to be protected. So the main problem is that if it is having a high population and having also a unique culture, so the shortage of development due to limited resources, because Delhi is union territory and union territory have not specific or special powers to develop the whole territory. So in 1987, Justice Balakrishnan Committee was formed and they concluded their things in a report, and the report talks about that Delhi should not be a union territory first. Second, Delhi should have its own legislative assembly with the council of ministers who are directly elected, which are responsible to the legislative assembly. So based on this report, the parliament passed 69th Constitutional Amendment Act 1991. And now the status of Delhi changed or converted to the new status named NCT, that is National Capital Territory of Delhi. Now, what it is? This amendment gave us two articles. First article is Article 239 AA and Article 239 AB. Article 239 AA talks about special status of NCT of Delhi. Second, Delhi should have its own legislative assembly. The Council of Ministers headed by the Chief Minister who are directly elected. And third, the foremost and the new emergence of a problem related to Delhi is the Council of Ministers or the legislature of Delhi are not allowed to make any law on entry number 1 to 18 of the state list. Because now Delhi, if the Delhi have its own legislative assembly, it's definitely have a state list. So they are not allowed to make any law in or about entry number 1, 2 and 18. Because these entry numbers or these particular department are, these particular entries are in the control of union. And what about Article 3, 239AB? 239AB talks about if the 239AA fails to function, then the whole, then the president should can suspend the Article 239AA and take over the whole control of the particular territory in his hand. Now, the entry number 1, 2, and 18 of the state list is what? What's the importance of these entry number? So, entry number 1 deals with the public order. Entry number 2 deals with the policing. Entry number 18 is deals with the land. And all these comes under union. Chief Minister, here a special thing I want to tell you, that Chief Minister of Delhi is not appointed by the Lieutenant Governor as same in, as followed in every state. Here the Chief Minister of Delhi should be appointed by the President, and the Council of Ministers also appointed by the President on the advice of Chief Minister. And as per the 91st Constitutional Amendment, the the number of legislative the number of cabinet minister in legislative house should be less, or should be 10%, not 15%, as same in the state. So the question, my question is, what are the conflict with the NCT, that is National Capital Territory of Delhi, the Chief Minister and Lieutenant Governor? There are 2 persons. The Chief Minister of Delhi is de facto head, and the Lieutenant Governor is head of the administrative, or we can say constitutional head. So whenever any matter come with the conflict of these two, the Lieutenant Governor has to pass that particular matter for the consideration of President. And if there is a delay in the consideration of President, and the LG thinks and has an opinion that it is of great importance of the people of the territory, he can use his discretionary power. Now, discretionary power means that is, he is, that is legislative, that is Lieutenant Governor, is deemed to take necessitative action within a particular time. Discretionary power has a conflict, because it is against the rule of executive is responsible to the legislative. So we can say that now Lieutenant Governor is practically ruling over the NCT, not Chief Minister. So the problem arises with Delhi is that if Delhi government is not allowed to make any law regarding public order, policing and land, how does it possible that a government of Delhi can control the territory? Because there is a lack of administrative power and the Lieutenant Governor's interference almost in every level. And the foremost problem is that union has a control on public order, policing and land. So if union government or GUDAC, because they having a power or control over these three, so they automatically have a control on bureaucracy and services, etc., means that they are trying to hijacking the state list of the Delhi. This particular thing, as per our constitution, we can say that is a principle of incidental and ancillary power. So union is about to use that power, or union not about, it is using that power. It was, sorry, using that power. Now, what the Delhi government decided? The Delhi government, Mr. Arvind Kejriwal, decided to file a case in the Supreme Court, and they filed it. And on July 2018, the judgment passed by the Supreme Court And the judgment have three core points, and that three core points they solve the conflict with the Delhi. And the three core points are: first is discretionary power of Lieutenant Governor, that is LG, is limited to the public order, policing and land. Second is the LG should act as a facilitator between union and the and city government. It should not behave or act as an obstructionist. And the last and the most important thing is the Chief Minister of Delhi doesn't require to see or seek permission of the Lieutenant Governor for day-to-day operations. So on the basis of these judgment, the union argue in relation to the Supreme Court that their judgment hits the spirit of federalism of the constitution, as the federalism is the part of basic structure doctrine. Now the Supreme Court argued on this was, we can't ignore the will of the people of Delhi given to the directly elected government. So if we do that, it is ignorance of the democracy, and democracy is a part of basic structure doctrine. So here the Supreme Court takes or establishes a balance between federalism and democracy. So the two things at a conclusion is there are few points which are in the favor or in the against, and why this particular discussion we are doing, because recently in Delhi the government head Mr. Arvind Kejriwal was was demanded to the Supreme Court that we should have a full statehood status. So in the favor of a statehood status of a Delhi, we can say that because it have a large population, it should be, and we should respect the democratic elected government. So if we have a democratic elected government, so we should give that power that they can do some better things in the particular territory. And last thing is that in the favor, because if some power are limited to the union and some power limited to the territory, there must always be a conflict. So you should either treat Delhi, give the status of union territory only to the Delhi, or give state status. So if we will give Delhi as a state status, what will be the argument against this particular thing is, Delhi is not a union territory only. Delhi is the national capital of country, and it can't belong to a particular state or particular or anybody. Since a long time, since in 1911, Delhi is treated, or Delhi was the national capital of the country. So there is a sentimental attachment of people of India with the Delhi. Second thing is that many federal and bureaucratic structure or offices are located in Delhi. So can we trust a Delhi government to look after all these with consideration of national security? And the third one is, Balakrishnan committee never said about the Delhi as a state. The committee always talks about national capital territory. We should give some special status, not convert it as a state. So all these are about Delhi and the union territory or national territory, the national capital of a territory of Delhi. So now you are, after knowing all these things, now you are you I am very much sure that you are in the state, you are in the status that you can analyze that whether we Delhi can be a state or not, or as it is. Thank you very much.